Hi, and welcome to Outline Fly Fishing. Today we are going to show you guys two things. We are going to make legs for the daddy long leg flies that we're going to tie today. And then I'm going to show you the materials we're going to need. It's pretty cheap and it's a quick and easy fly to tie. And then we're going to do the step by step. Let's start with making the legs. So what you're going to need, or what I use, is I've got these turkey quills. I normally don't use this. I don't know what I will use it for, if not legs. So that's what we're going to make the legs of today. So what we start with is turkey quills, hackle plier, and some flames. Here's how you do it. Take out a bunch of the turkey quills fibers here. Put that aside. Even if you use a lighter or matches, doesn't really matter as long as you heat up the end of the hackle plier. Heat it up. Now pinch the lower end. Give it a good bend. Pinch a little higher up. Give it a good bend. Take that fiber away because it doesn't do anything. Now what you do after you've done that, let the fibers cool down. Snip it off and find something pointy like a needle. That one. Then you just pick them apart like this. So I'm gonna fast forward so you don't have to watch me do everything. So that's how we do the legs, quick, easy, and it works. It probably won't last as long as the knotted ones, or if you have any other way of making the legs, please leave a comment and I will try that out. The legs breaks, all I have to do is strip the fly and tie a new one on the hook. Now let's take a look at the materials needed for the fly. These are size 12 long shank dry fly hooks. These are the hooks I'm going to be using today. Then I'm going to be using black thread March brown colored fly right dubbing. Poly yarn. Only thing I hate about this poly yarn is that it comes on this card. Reason why is because it gives it a kink right at the edge of the card here. So that sucks, but otherwise the yarn is perfect. Then we are going to need some hackle. I've chosen this brown, ginger, orange, whatever hackle. So we're gonna be using these materials. And now I'm gonna show, and of course, sorry, of course, the legs we just made. So, pretty cheap materials, and the only thing missing here is, of course, something you all know. A cup. Some coffee. And something I'm sure most of you know, but not everyone. Schnish! So the step-by-step part is gonna be a quick, easy, and fugly fly. But I'm gonna show you either way, because this fly has saved my day so many times. What we're gonna need for this fly is the size 12 long shank dry fly hook. What I did before I put the hook in the vise was to pinch down the barb. I always pinch down the barb. Don't see the point of it. Only hurts the fish. The hook can't grab onto the fish. You have a fucked up hook. Next thing is to put down a layer of thread onto the shank. When you get about halfway, you can snip the tag end off. Right by the band. I do not know where I got this wax from. It was part of the materials I got from a friend, and it's this one. If anyone has anything to say about this, please leave a comment below. I want to know as much as I can, because I really do love this one. And this is what we're gonna use. You can probably use every other type of wax. That's the one I'm using. So wax the thread. Next thing up is the fly rod. Now make a thin dubbing noodle onto the thread and give it a couple of wraps up to about 2/3 of the hook. The next step would of course be to put on the legs. That's four. Let's do two more. Clean up the area. Like that. So that's the legs. So next thing is the wing. Scissors. Next thing is the hackle, and I'm going to find a hackle that has fibers sticking a little bit further than the gap of the hook. This one looks good. I'm stripping down the fibers from one end of the feather here and keeping the ones on top here. Start wrapping the hackle. I make just a quick whip finish. Then I grab another pair of hackle pliers, not the one I used with the flames, because it has all this soot on the end of it and it kind of colors the feather, and you don't want that. grab it. Then, oh, I'm sorry. We start wrapping the hackle. Camera's in the way. I'm just gonna pull that back just to get room for the head here. Tie it off, secure the end of the hackle, quick whip finish. Tighten it up. Snip off the thread. Rotate the vise just to see if there's any trapped hackles we need to get rid of. But this is the finished fly. All you have to do now is to put some varnish on the head and you're good to go. So I'm gonna put this fly onto this wine cork and we're gonna take some close-up look at the fly. So this is the fly we just tied, and this is how it looks from the front of it. And as you can see, if you burn off the ends of the wings, you get these two perfect wings there. This is from the side. As you can see, all the legs are sticking out in different directions. No, actually these two are stuck together. I'm gonna fix that. And you have this long slim body. But all in all, it's a great fly and it saved my day so many times. I never leave the house without this one in my box. And this is just one of the million different ways to tie the fly. And I just wanted to show you this pattern because I know there's a lot of you out there who loves this daddy long leg pattern and probably has three different patterns in your fly box, but this is a cheap way, easy way, and a fast way to do it. So I'm gonna wait a bit longer before I start fishing. Had a couple of trips, I'm gonna see if I can make some movies out of that. And yeah, well, it's just stay tuned, there's a lot of projects going on. So tight lines, everyone.